So I'd begun to get into using softer light. So in the studio, I asked for big ceiling pieces to put in above the spot rail. I still use the spot rail, but I had a ceiling piece above the rail into which I could bounce a couple of 10Ks, which gave me like a soft fill, top light, which kind of filled in some of the dark areas, because you had to fill in a little bit more in those days, the stock we had then. You had to give it a little bit more filler. And, you know, it was felt nice to get something into the shadows. And I was still using, in the studio, I was still using mainly a hard soft light and trying to fill in with softer light for fill-in. So the key light might be hard and the soft light filler, the fill light soft. And we used pieces of flat painted white to bounce light off to fill in with. But of course it was a bit cumbersome. And over the years, of course, getting fill light in has become so much easier with the development of polystyrene, which gives a lovely white surface, and it's so lightweight and easy to fix. Over the years, it became much easier to get a soft fill light in without going to a great deal of rigging. Rigging time is lost time. When I think back to how long it took to light a set in those days, it was partly, you were mainly waiting for things to be put in position because the equipment was so heavy and the cable was so heavy that you're very often just saying, well, I want a lamp there. And then you wait 5 or 10 minutes until it gets there. Nowadays, equipment is so much lighter that you can get things into place a lot easier.
And of course,
the advantage of pre-rigging is terribly important too, to have a set pre-rigged so that things are all in position.